The photography industry is incredibly diverse. There's professionals and hobbyists, enthusiasts, newbies, and these guys. But let's go through some of the examples you're bound to meet along the way. Number one, Mr. Rebel. This is the guy who rocks a Canon Rebel circa 2007 and somehow shoots photos that make you question why you picked up a camera in the first place. What gives? Is it his affinity for light? Is it the attention to detail? Is it the fact that he's been shooting since you were in diapers? Or is it his 90s ponytail and reader glasses that helps him get to the upper echelon of the greats? Whatever it is, we'll never know. Number two, Mr. Moneybags. Now, this is the guy that you'll find rocking a Phase 1 XF or Leica Q2 and has an array of different lenses that'll put the biggest camera store to shame. There's two things certain about this guy. First, he's gonna point out how inferior your camera is. I mean, come on, buddy, if we can all afford a $20,000 camera, we'd all buy one. We all know that you're either A, eyeballs in debt, or B, incredibly well off. Who am I kidding? I want a Leica Q2. Second, these guys never have the skill to match the hardware. They're fumbling more around with their camera than Brett Favre fumbling footballs throughout his entire career. Number three, Film Bro. Kodak Ektar 100, Fujifilm Velvia, Kodak Portra. These guys have it all. Their fridges are stocked to the ceiling with film, and I guarantee they're gonna tell you about it. Film is better than digital, bro. Digital sucks, bro. Have you tried a real camera, bro? One thing's for sure about Film Bro. He's probably reminiscing about that one time he had a studio and shot in a white background in the 80s and 90s during his glory years. He's gonna show you his portfolio filled with mediocre photos from a less than PC time. In there, you're gonna find a treasure trove of oddities, probably better left to the imagination. And I guarantee that it's gonna make you feel uncomfortable. So, good luck. Number four, the Workshop Junkie. The Workshop Junkie has season passes to every major photography event around the globe. They have every event scheduled down to a science. No one knows how they do it all. PPE, I'm in. WPPI, I'm in. Society of Portrait Photographers in Antarctica, founding member. The secret to Workshop Junkies is no one knows how they're able to afford it all, but they mysteriously show up at every single event like a cold sore in December. If you look at a portfolio of a Workshop Junkie, it looks like a dining menu from a 1960s diner. It's a little bit of everything, but nothing specific, which is why the Workshop Junkie is so adamant about going to just one more workshop. Sure, Workshop Junkie, we all believe you. Number five, the art school student. Trained in the most prestigious schools in the world, the art student is ready to become the next Ansel Adams. After all, they've studied light theory and color theory for years. They know lighting ratios, they've mastered composition, and they have a six-figure loan to prove it. But one thing's for sure about the art student, they won't put those talents to waste. You'll likely find them crafting complex latte art at your local Starbucks until they catch their next big break. Number six, the know-it-all. He's the guy who has photography broken down to a science. He's likely graduated art school, kicked his workshop junkie habit, and finally realized that digital cameras are the way of the future. He's done it all, and he's going to tell you all about it. He's gonna mention obscure references to cameras and lighting techniques he's learned along his travels and why things are not what they used to be. No matter how successful you are as a photographer, the know-it-all will remind you that they're always better. Now, let's be honest, the bark doesn't match their bite. What you'll find in the know-it-all's portfolio is an assortment of underexposed, blurry, and generic photos taken over the course of the last 20 years. Nothing to gloat about. But hey, who's judging? And finally, number seven, the guru, also known as the baby know-it-all. If you combine the knowledge of the know-it-all with the entrepreneurship ability of your friend Becky from high school with the multi-level marketing company, then you'd get the guru. You either love the guru or you hate the guru. There's no in-between. But one thing's for sure, they'll have a shtick. Whether that's wearing their own name on their own swag, wearing the same color which inevitably makes them look like a human crayon, or yelling weird phrases that they expect everyone else to chant. You can't miss them. They're surrounded by fans who look just like them, dress just like them, and are part of their cult-like multi-level marketing platforms selling their basic lighting setups like it's Mary Kay. There's no time requirement to become a guru either. Chances are, they've done one lighting setup really well, and then that went viral, so now they're selling workshops, ebooks, and presets like it's going out of style. And those are the first seven photographers you'll meet along your photography journey. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe. Have an incredible day.